Hello, good morning everybody. And this time I am just coming with a second video with slightly more clarifications on the Vivadi Ragas. And I also hope that during these corona days, all my friends are all having a safe life, staying inside the home, only making travels which are so acutely necessary, essential. Then only one has to travel, then wear all safety protocols, mask, washing hands for cleanliness, and also kindly do some pranayama, deep breathing exercises for at least some 10 to 15 minutes daily, plus some 10 minute sun bath, early morning sun bath before 9 o'clock or 10 o'clock will definitely add up the vitamin D, which is very essential vitamin for the basic immunity. So hope I will continue with the video on Vivadi Ragas. This Vivadi Ragas, as per definition, the earlier video I was telling, at least one pair of notes must be adjacent, which is deferred, which is having an interval of one shruti. We have 12 shrutis, I already explained. And these 12 shrutis, and if you see, if you can see this figure, I will explain with the help of this figure, a little bit theory, but it's simple, it's not so complicated. And this is one octave, or one sthayi, we call it. So one octave means the lower sa, the lower shajja, and the upper shajja. In the mid C scale of any harmonium or keyboard, our frequency is 261.63 is the hertz. 261.63 hertz is identified for C, mid C, lower C. So higher octave C will be 523.26. So this is one octave. In between we are spacing. We have a spacing of 12 tonal positions, which occupies 7 swaras. 7 swaras are occupying 12 tonal positions. First you see is the sa lower, R1, this R1, I will call it Re1, R2 is Re3, R2 is Re2, which is same as Ga1. We call it, this is R1 is Shuddhirishabham, R2 is Chadurshudhirishabham, G1 is Shuddha Gandhara, which I have already explained, which is in Ganamurti. Ganamurti, this Shuddha Gandharam and Shuddhirishabham are giving the Vivadi pair. Next is R3, which is Shashru Devadam, or G2, that is Sadharana Gandhara. Next is G3, which is not sharing its tonal position with any other note. This is known as Andhara Gandhara, which is a higher Gandhara. M1 is a smaller Madhyama, M2 is higher Madhyama, which is known as Prati Madhyama. This is Shuddha Madhyama. P is the Panchama, which is at the almost, not at the mid, almost at the mid. Then D1 is Shuddha Daivadam, okay. D2 is Chatushruti Daivadam, which is sharing another tonal position for lower knee, which is Shuddha Nishadam. Next is D3, which is Shatshruti Daivadam. That is also sharing its tonal position with the N2. That is, N2 is Kaisika Nishadam. Okay, Kaisika Nishadam. Next, the topmost, just below the higher sa, is Kagali Nishadam. N3, which is not sharing its tonal position with any other. So, if you sum up, this will be 16, total 16. But we have 12 tonal positions and 7 notes. Yes, upper will have the higher octave sa. So Vivadi Raga, any Vivadi Raga will have one pair of this semitonal positions, you call it. These positions are known as R2, R3. This I have again marked with an arrow. See, this pair, R1, R2 pair can give a Vivadi combination. R2, R3 or G1, G2 or R2, G2 or R3, G1 pair can give another Vivadi pair. Then R3, G3 or G2, G3 pair can give, can produce a Vivadi Raga. If the any Raga uses this pair showed with the arrow. This arrow shows D1 and D2. That is also one pair which can cause Vivadi Raga. D1, D2 or D1, N1. Again, N1, N2, this is not to scale, so don't get confused with the larger distance. D2, D3 or N1, N2 or D2, D3 or N1, N2. Okay, or N1, D3. Like that. So this pair can also contribute, give rise to a Vivadi Raga. Then another three is N3, N2, the Kagali and Kaisi Nishadam, or N3 and D3. This pair also can give, contribute or create a Vivadi Raga. These are all known as semitonal positions. If you go to Western music scale, there also these 12 divisions are there. And they call these semitonal positions, semitonal position, half tones. These half tones are is the Vivadi notes, which are creating this Vivadi dosha. This is known as Vivadi dosha. It gives slightly less pleasure, musical pleasure, enjoyment. And again, one more point I need to clarify is that when the notes are close, as I said, musician has got very less freedom to use Kampita Gamaka, oscillate show the bhava of the raga. Because if you can represent it by a bell curve, and if these are close, if the mid-tonal positions are close, means I cannot oscillate because both the notes will collide. My freedom is curtailed. That's what I was explaining in the last video. You can go to the valley, but not to the capital. In the sense, you can encroach into the valley, but not encroach into the capital or the tonal midpoint position. In an analogy. So this create actually in physics in high school physics we have all studied that beat phenomena. When two frequencies are coming very close, it generates a beat phenomena, and that beat phenomena is also actually in music. When we sing, this beat phenomena is also being generated when we sing Vivadi Raga. That is why it is not giving, it is not experiencing as an appealing tonal interval. So this beat is creating an issue. So these are the points which I wanted to clarify again. But this Gamaka, what I was explaining, though we cannot use Kampita Gamaka, definitely other forms of Gamaka can be used, like Jande Gamaka and Glide, Jaru Gamaka, etc. Take the case of Vagadeeswari. Vagadeeswari is a Vivadi Raga, very popular Vivadi Raga. It uses the highest tree, Shatshudra Rishabham. Ga, that is the Andhra Gandhara. Highest Rishabham, Andhra Gandhara. This pair it uses. So it's a Vivadi Raga. Again, it uses another Vivadi pair. Padani. Dani, that is the Chatushri Daivadam and the Kaisiki Nishadam, D2 and N2. This is another Vivadi pair. So these two pairs are giving Vagadeeswari the name of Vivadi Raga. It is classified as Vivadi Raga because of these two pairs. Sariga Ma Padani Sa. Padanisa, there you can have slight freedom of oscillation of knee possible. That is why Vagadeeswari has become a popular, though it has got two Vivadi prays, Padani Sa. Smallerly, Sani Dapa Magari, Sani Dapa. Da, you cannot dwell or oscillate. Sani Dapa Magari. Plain notes, you have to sing it as plain note. Pamagari. Na 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 na. It uses Shuddha Madhyamam. And when it uses Pradhima Madhyamam, it becomes Nasika Bhoshan. Tarari na 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 na. This is the 34th Melagartha Ragam of the Venkata Mugi scale, which is also known as Bhoga Chaya Nata. Na 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 ra 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 no na 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 ra na 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 vani vagadishwari vani vagadishwari வரமருவாய் இசை வாணி கலை வாணி வாக பமகமகாரி தபமகாரி காரி பமரி கரி சகாரி சகரி சரி கமக சகாரி ச பமக மக மரி கம பமக மரி காரி கரி ரி சரி ஜெண்டை ஜெண்டை யூ கேன் யூஸ் இட் வெரி ஃப்ரீக்வெண்ட்லி இன் திஸ் டைப் ஆஃப் விவாத ராகாஸ் ப ப ம க ம ப த த ப ப ம ம க க ம ம க க ரி ரி ச த ரி ரி க க ம ம ப ரி ரி க க ம ம ப த த நி நி ச வ த த நி நி ச த ரி ரி ச நி ச ரி ரி க க ம ம க க ரி ரி ச ச ம க க ரி ரி ச நி ச ரி ரி ச நி ச ரி க க ம க க ரி ரி ச நி ச க ரி ச நி ரி ச ரி ச ச நி த ச க ரி ரி ச ச நி நி த த ப ம ப த த நி நி த த ப ப ம ப த த ப ப ம ம க க ரி ரி ச ச நி நி ச ச ரி ரி ச ச நி நி த நி sa re ga ma ga re ga re ga re sa. Thank you.